Hello, welcome to New Vision TV News around Uganda. I am Rathina Sijie, and here we look at stories making headlines across the country. We kickstarted with this bulletin from Mbarara District. Police are investigating circumstances surrounding the death of another Swedish citizen who was found dead in a guest house in Nyamichoboro Ward, Kakuba Division in Mbarara District yesterday. The deceased was identified as Musi Walter Haimanot. According to police preliminary investigations, the Swedish national is suspected to have committed suicide. The body of Musi was found hanging in a room he hired last on Tuesday night. Police recovered from the room a note stating that he decided to kill himself, but he gave no reason for taking his life. In the note, the man reportedly requested police to inform the Swedish embassy and his relatives about his death. Mbarara OCCID Mutabazi confirmed the information and said the body of the deceased was to be taken to Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital for further investigation. This is the second Swedish nation to be found dead in a hotel room in Uganda in the past few months. He is also one of the over six foreign nationals who have died in Uganda during the same period. Moving on to Mbale District, four people were killed and two others admitted to Mbale Hospital in a critical condition after a Toro cement truck overturned as it was crossing a condemned bridge that joins Karamoja to Bugisu and Sebei region. The truck was carrying merchandise from Mbale heading to Amdat District. It overturned when the Chuptai Bridge along Muyembe Nakapit Bridge Road collapsed at around 10 p.m. The dead were identified as Daniel Lodome, Lodoa, Naka, and Lokaria, all from Lora Sub-County in Amdat District. The two who survived with injuries were identified as Rogers Buburu and Abbas Waduasi from Mbale. The driver too survived but disappeared. Elgon Regional Police spokesperson Muswa Sowedi say the bridge developed a crack over 10 years ago and was condemned. Motorists were barred from using it and an alternative route provided, but some motorists still insisted on using the condemned bridge. Before we move on to other stories making headlines across the country, let's look at what is making headlines in today's copy of the New Vision. And the headlining story is IGG stops Bank of Uganda staff transfers. We also have Kaihura hands over office today to Omo Okothi Ochola. In the New Vision, we have Ginger East votes today. So we have details. We also have fake hepatitis vaccine used. So you should check out on the story and find out more details on which is a fake hepatitis B vaccine. From the business pullout, which comes out every Thursday, we have dead ferry costs UNRWA billions of shillings. Find out why and why is it costing the roads authority so many billions. From the New Vision, we have the Motomart pullout. The story here that you can read in your copy is pollution vehicles turn Kampala into a death trap. We have those details. And from sports, we have KBRA is back. KBRA is Kabaka's birthday run. It is back and it was launched yesterday. We also have Team Uganda confident of registering good times in Algeria. So find these details in today's copy at only 2,000 shillings. And remember, we are the leading daily. Yeah, now we can move on to other stories making headlines. But remember, you can find more stories around Uganda in your copy of the New Vision in the regional section. But I have more, and let's go to Mbarara District. Now, the vaccine against hepatitis B that was given to people in Western Uganda was unregistered, possibly unsafe, and probably fake. Dr. Medad Bitechelezo, the chairman of the board of the National Drug Authority, has said. He revealed this at a press conference held in Mbarara municipality. Bitechelezo said they had information with evidence that some people in Mbarara and in Tungamo districts were producing labels of the hepatitis B vaccine, repackaging it, and the fake vaccine had been supplied to different health units and hospitals. news. He said the vaccine had been injected into thousands of innocent Ugandans. It's a sad story there, so please check before you go to, before you get the vaccine of hepatitis B. We move on to other stories making headlines, and from Kataqui, district teachers who defiled school children should be hanged or put on the firing squad. The Kataqui district chairperson, Walter Elkas Ekuringe, has said. Ekuringe said this would reduce cases of defilement involving teachers in the district and the entire country. This was during a dialogue meeting with stakeholders in preparation for the International Women's Day belated celebrations in Kataqui district slated for today. The meeting was organized by Ray of Hope, Action Aid Uganda, and the Kataqui Local Rights Program in Urafiki Foundation in Kataqui Town. Finally, from Kagadi District, the police has arrested a 40-year-old crime preventer for committing adultery with a married man. The CID Muhoro Police Post, Edward Muhumuza, identified the suspects as Edson Abigaba from Chesamire in Muhoro Sub-County and Consolanta Kumhanji, 45 years, wife to Ale Reader, Nathan Birunji of Chakorongoto Church of Uganda Sub-County in Muhoro Sub-County. And that's all we had for you. Thank you for watching. Be sure to catch more news updates and other programs here on New Vision TV by visiting our website, www.newvision.co.ug. I am Roethi Nasije.